So hello everyone, so today we were discussing about what is photography and the three types of photography. So photography is the art of producing an image by recording light with a camera. Photographers use their camera to make us see life in a different way, feel emotions, and record stories and events. The world's first photograph, or at least the oldest surviving photo, was taken by Joseph Nasifa Napse in 1826. The photograph was taken from the upstairs window of Napse's estate in the Burgundy region of France. It was captured using a technique known as heliography. Okay, let's proceed to the three basic types of photography. The first type of photography is the landscape photography. Landscape photograph typically capture the presence of nature and the outdoor in a way that bring our viewer into the scene. Through landscape photography, the photographers demonstrate their connection to nature and capture the essence of the environment around them. So the second type of photography is the portrait photography. Portrait photography, it aims to capture the identity, personality, and essence of the subject, utilizing photographic techniques such as the composition, lighting, and posing. There are various types of portrait photography that are dependent on the subject of the portrait as well as the style. So the last type of photography is the documentary photography. So in this kind of photography, using our camera to chronicle a real people and events in a truthful and objective way, it can be centered in our everyday life and how people live, for example, or focused on capturing a particular aspect of a culture.
Okay, so now let's talk about exposure. So exposure is a measure of how bright a photo as it's saved to your memory card, sometimes referred to as a finished image. So pag sinabi natin exposure, it is the amount of light that reaches your camera sensor. So you can adjust the settings of your camera para makita mo if that camera or that photo is exposed to the light. So exposure is affected by four things. So first is light, shutter sound, aperture, and ISO. So to capture the image with determined brightness, when you shoot a perfectly exposed photo, you are capturing all the details in the highlights and shadows. So when you are using your camera, doon mo ma-adjust yung sinasabi nating exposure. So what are the difference between overexposed and underexposed? So when we say underexposed, it is when the images that are darker than the actual scene, while overexposed is those that are brighter. So when we say underexposed, yun po yung mga images na hindi po masyadong exposed sa light and yung background, the details is darker. And the overexposed is yun po yung mga images na masyadong exposed sa light. At makikita mo is brighter po yung images, which is yung details and the background itself. So let's talk about the photographic triangle. So photographic triangle is a correct exposure, is a simple combination of three important factors: aperture, shutter sound, and ISO. Okay, so aperture, it is the size of the hole in the diaphragm that allows light into the camera. The larger the hole, the more light that enters the camera in a given time. So yung aperture po is yun po yung size ng camera, and I think every photographer know this, right? Size of the hole is larger, meron po makikita, more light po yung makikita mo. And when the diaphragm or the hole na makikita mo sa camera is maliit, dun po makikita yung less light. The aperture and depth of field. So the aperture does more than just control the amount of light that hits the sensor. The size of the aperture affects the way an image looks well. So yung aperture po is siya po yung nagko-control ng amount of light that enters the camera. So when the hole or the diaphragm in the camera is large, doon po is makikita mo is the bigger the hole in the camera, the more brighter the image look. And when the hole in the camera is small, so the less the light that enters the camera.
So now, let's talk about AV and TV together. AV or aperture lets you control your depth of field by either opening or closing your aperture. And TV, or time value, lets you control how you freeze motion by either speeding up or slowing down your shutter speed. Our next topic is shutter speed. The function of the shutter's mechanism is to admit light into the camera and into a digital media of film for a specific length of time. For example, a slow shutter speed of 1/2 means the shutters remain open for half a second, while a faster speed of 1/2000 means it only remains open for 1/2000 of a second. And take note, the faster shutter speed means less light, only the image sensor. Slower shutter speed means more light. Next is shutter speed in motion capture. A shutter speed of 1/250 seconds should be fast enough to freeze people walking around, whereas 1/500 seconds is better if your subject is moving a bit quicker. For a faster object such as car and birds in flight, shutter speed of 1/2000 seconds and 1/400 seconds are quicker as preferred. For example, the camera shutter speed determines how the action in the photo is recorded. A fast shutter speed can freeze actions, even stopping a hummingbird's wings. For example, on the screen, a slow shutter speed can let action blur or even make a moving subject seems to disappear. Next is film speed, or ISO. Film speed is a measure of a film's sensitivity to light. It is commonly referred to as the film's ISO rating, while the most common film's speed being ISO 400, ISO 200, and ISO 100. If one film has doubled the ISO rating for another, that means that is twice as sensitive to light and may be called a faster film. In short, the ISO rating of a film is a measure of the film's sensitivity to light. High ISO films are most sensitive to light and therefore suitable for low light situation or when a fast shutter speed is required. Typically, ISO film rating include ISO 100, 200, 400, 800, and 1600. Films with a high ISO are called fast film. Films with a low ISO are called slow film. The slow ISO rating is equivalent to ASA light rating. ISO 100 equal ASA 100. ISO 400 equal 400 ASA.
So now let's talk about stop. The exposure value is the amount of light that hits the film or chip measured in stop. A one-stop difference equates the doubling or halving of a light in the image. It used to measure differences, apertures, and shutter speed and film speed. And here the example of stop. So now let's talk about lighting. Light is the essential ingredients of photos, one of the skills that separates photographers. And here the example of lighting. So let's talk about lighting direction. The direction the light comes from can make the image seem flat or three-dimensional. Front lighting is easy to photography, but images are generally flat. Top lighting is just as from the sun overhead, also makes image flat and shadows are short and dark. Side lighting will emphasize texture, contours, and create long shadows.
And here the example of lighting direction.
So now let's talk about lighting color. The color of light is measured by temperature in Kelvin.
Natural light changes through the day and human respond physiological to different color. Therefore, the color of a photo will affect emotional responses. Light that is in the red, orange, and yellow is said to be warm. Conversely, cool light is blue in tone.
Top 10 tips in taking great pictures. The first one in the list is get down in their level. Direct eye contact can be as engaging in a picture as it is in real life. When taking a picture of someone, hold the camera at the person's eye level to unleash the power of those magnetic gazes and mesmerizing smiles. Number 2. Use a plain background. A plain background shows off the subject you are photographing. When you look through the camera viewfinder, force yourself to study the area surrounding your subject. Number 3. Use flash outdoors. Bright sun can create an attractive deep facial shadows. Eliminate the shadows by using your flash to lighten the face. When taking pictures of sunny days, turn your flash on. Next is move in close. If your subject is smaller than a car, take a step or two closer before taking the picture and zoom in on your subject. Your goal is to fill the picture area with the subject you are photographing. Next, take some vertical pictures. All sorts of things look better in vertical pictures. From a lighthouse near a cliff to the Eiffel Tower to your 4-year-old niece jumping in a puddle. So next time, make a conscious effort to turn your camera sideways and take some vertical pictures. Next, lock the focus. If your subject is not in the center of the picture, you need to lock the focus to create a sharp picture. Most autofocus cameras focus on whatever in the center of the picture. But to improve pictures, you will often want to move the subject away from the center of the picture. Next, move it from the middle. Center stage is a great place for a performer to be. However, the middle of your picture is not the best place for your subject. Bring your picture to life by simply moving your subject away from the middle of your picture. Next, know your flash range. The number one flash mistake is taking pictures beyond the flash range. Because pictures taken beyond the maximum flash range will be too dark. For many pictures, the maximum flash range is less than 15 feet, about 5 steps away. Next, watch the light. Next to the subject, the most important part of every picture is the light. It affects the appearance of everything you photograph. On a great-grandmother, bright sunlight from the side can enhance wrinkles, but the soft light of a cloudy day can subdue those same wrinkles. Lastly, be a picture director. Take control of your picture taking and watch your pictures dramatically improve. A picture director takes charge. Most pictures won't be that involved, but you get the idea. Take charge of your pictures and win your own Best Picture Awards. Now let's move on to post-processing. Post-processing is the process of editing the data captured by camera while taking the photo to enhance the image. It can also help to enhance the image. Post-processing encompasses every change you make to a video or photo after you download the raw file to your computer. It's the process that takes unrefined images and polishes them into perfect captures. The fundamentals of post-processing include everything from cropping to sharpening. Next is post-processing software. There are two things done in post-processing. The first one is an algorithm is run on all existing data of pixel and minor changes are applied to pixel data. Second, manual selecting and replacing the pixel data with total new data. JPEG file editing is generally done in image editors that have various features such as green and red eye removal. For example, the GIMP, Adobe Photoshop, or Photoshop Elements. Let's move on to the workflow of post-processing. The sequence of these changes is important as change made at one stage can affect the effectiveness of the next stages. Here are the actions that may be preferred while editing raw file. Number 1. Exposure value adjustment. Adjusting the exposure value can help you achieve different creative effects in your photography. For example, if you want to capture motion blur, you can lower the EV by using a smaller aperture a slower shutter speed, or a lower ISO. This will allow you to show the movement of your subject or the background. It also refers to the amount of light used in capturing the image. Less light than needed, the photo will be dark or underexposed. Excess light, the other way around. The exposure tool compensates for too much or too little light, but used carefully. Increasing its value excessively may add to noise to the image. Second, white balance adjustment. White balance is the adjustment of a digital photograph to make its colors appear more realistic. It's a way to set a photograph to neutral, to make the white look white, says photographer and educator Adam Long. Third, hue and tone adjustment. Adjusting the hue allows you to shift the color values of your images, a process that can radically change the emotional impact of your photograph. Altering the hue to achieve a complementary color scheme, for instance, can create an image that is aesthetically balanced and unified. Also, hue is called tint. If an old color photo has got a color cast or sepia tones, a slight adjustment with this tool may correct them. Use it liberally, and you'll change the picture's color entirely for a surreal feel. Next, highlight and shadow recovery. Lower the highlight slider to darken the brightest sections of the image and recover lost detail or increase it to make your brightest areas even lighter. More often than not, the sky will be brighter than you want, and the shadows will be darker than you want. As a result, photos straight off the camera don't look the way your eyes were perceiving the scene, and that's where highlight and shadow recovery becomes critical. Next, vibrance and saturation adjustment. If the image is very colorful but only needs small enhancements, the vibrance tool should be used. If the colors in the image are muted, the saturation tool should help them bring to light. Next, cropping and rotation. The composition of a photo is often just as important as what appears within the frame. If you're not happy with the image's original framing, or you want to exercise distracting elements like tree branches from the edges, recompose the shot using the crop tool. Crop tool offers another important, seldom mentioned possibility. Most cameras have digital zoom, and using it gives low-resolution photos. You should never zoom when shooting with a fixed-lens phone camera, but what you could do is to take in just a bit more of the scene that you need, and then crop to achieve the exact composition you want. And next is, some actions that can be done at RAW or JPEG stage are noise reduction. Photo noise reduction is a way to reduce image noise in post-processing. Photo editing software smoothens the image by evaluating the differences values of adjacent pixels. They may use the intensity or the color of the pixel as a reference. Sharpening. Sharpening enhances the definition of edges in an image. Whether your images come from a digital camera or a scanner, most images can benefit from sharpening. And always keep in mind that sharpening cannot correct a severely blurred image. Now let's move on to some actions that are preferred after conversion to JPEG files. Red eye removal. Red eye will remove the red discoloration of a person's eyes that can result from a camera flash going off. Pet eye will remove the yellow or green discoloration that can occur in your photos of pets. Next, local touch-up of clothing to erase unwanted object in the frame. The impact of a photo can easily be spoiled by an unwanted object in the frame. As you've seen, the recompose tool lets you remove areas as you scale a photo. In the set of exercises, you'll use the spot healing brush tool to remove an object without altering the overall composition. Next is adding of frame. Famous photographers often use framing to achieve a variety of effects. Framing can provide the context for the photo and tell the viewer something about the person or a place where it was made, or it can create an illusion of depth. A third dimension are various layers in a photographer's. Last, mixing with other JPEG files like changing the background.